Hello everyone, I am going to talk a little bit about how you can make a native village, or for those people doing missions, you can add a native structure to your to the outside of your mission. Most of the people living in the missions were indigenous, were natives. They weren't from Spain or Mexico. They were native peoples from California. And so a lot of the storage structures and structures around the borders of a mission would have been created in an indigenous style. And remember, most of the missions were completely built and staffed by native California people. So they are built by California natives for California natives. But back to our native villages. So everybody has gotten a big piece of foam core. And remember, your imagination is there are no limits. It's whatever you can imagine. I gave each of you some examples, but you can do a lot more research as to what a village may have looked like. So you do not have to do it exactly like I'm doing it. Not important. Do it the way you want to do it. So each different group of peoples made their houses a little differently. I'm actually going to make two different kinds of houses that would normally not necessarily be next to each other, but I just want to give you some idea of how to use your bag of materials, which should look something like this. So most villages were built near water. Water is always very important to have a source of water to drink, a place to catch fish, a place that will nurture growing things that you can harvest to eat. So whether it's by a swamp, a river, the bay, an ocean, you need some water. So I'm just going to draw on our foam core. A shore could be a river shore, could be a beach. It's up to you. In my case, I'm thinking of it more like a river, but there's, you know, it's up to you and to what fits best with the group of people you're representing. So eventually I am going to paint some water and then some ground. And then when that is dry, I will go on. So I'm gonna just record for a little while me painting, and that will be fast forwarded and we'll get to the next section. Hi everybody. So this was the sort of the base that I made earlier. So this is a river and this is the shore of the river. And then this is like ground. And I gave everybody a bunch of supplies. Now you can go out and go out to a park or outside and find some other things. I found some rocks outside. You can use sand, you can use leaves, you can use anything you want. Your imagination is the limit. One thing you can do is make people out or people or a canoe or anything you want using clay. I gave everybody at least some terracotta clay. Now I actually found these little tiny figures somewhere on Amazon. But they were hard to find and they took a long time to get here. But it gives you a good size of like how big to make your figures. And you can make them out of clay.
It fits perfectly with the mission too.
Yeah, these are exactly the right size for the mission. And I actually need to paint it because it's all one color. But, you know, so this is kind of the size you're looking at. However, you can change the scale. If you want to make everything a little bit bigger, you can do that too. I'm going to make a house that I think is a little bit like an Ohlone house. And those are usually made out of tule reed. I do not have tule reed. You can sometimes see tule growing on the edges of a swamp that it used to grow all around the bay. It still grows in some areas, but it was a very big building tool used by many Native peoples. I gave everybody some straw like this. So there's a big bag of thick straw and then thin straw. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use, this is part of an egg carton. Okay, so I'm actually going to cut this up and use it as a base for my house. And let your imagination work. It's usually easier to create a structure if you have something sort of under it as like the base of it. So I am using this egg carton because it's easy to to shape, and it's easy to glue stuff onto. But you could use, I have this little cup. You can use whatever you want, or you could try to just make it just of the materials, like the sticks and stuff, but it's going to be much harder. So I recommend finding some kind of a base, or making a base out of like cardboard or something to be the base of your house. So every village, you're going to need some people, you're going to need places that people lived. You might want to add places where people stored stuff. A really important part of life in a majority of California was the acorn harvest. Acorns provided a lot of food for people. So I know among the Ohlone, the acorn harvest was very important. Also among the Miwok and the Yokut people. So I may build like a little storage thing. I'm going to build an Ohlone style house, and then I'm going to build a Pomo or Miwok style bark house. So I'm going to just see it. And I've never done this before. I'm inventing as I go. You guys can invent too. I just want to show you the kind of things you could be doing.
Thank you.
Okay, everyone. So I built some stuff and you can watch me do it. You just watched me do it. It didn't take that long. And this is not really good enough. Okay. This is an Ohlone style house, but if I was really doing this for a project, I would spend a lot longer trying to really make it like cover up everything underneath. Try and make it look as much as the pictures or drawings that you can find online looks like. Same, this is a like kind of like a Miwok bark house, but it needs about 10 more layers of sticks or bark you can get off of a tree in order to look more real. I'm just showing you how you can start it. This is a little person. I only spent a few minutes on it. If you spend more time, you can make it look more like a person. This could be a basket, especially if I painted it. It would look like an Ohlone style basket. Here is a fire, but you could add some paper to make it actually look like flames. This is a very, very quick Tule boat, Tule reed boat. They were used by Ohlone and Yokut people. There's a different kind that was used by the Chumash that were made like boards. And there's lots of other things. You could add trees, you could add hills. Some Ohlone built giant shell mounds that were just these huge mounds built out of shells that were actually kind of shiny. You could see them from a long ways away. They were almost like mini pyramids. There's all kinds of neat things. Do your research, look stuff up online, especially on the pages of the actual tribe. A lot of tribes have pages that talk about their past and what their building style is. A lot of them still make traditional homes as part of rituals and things like that. So find out what you can from the sources from the nations that you chose or were given. And try and have fun with it. Make your own village. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me or Ms. Hook.